Hello, my name is Rainer Hanekamp. This is Engine News with the latest updates from the Angular community in 100 seconds every week. Angular 17.1 was released according to plan. Its main new feature are the signal inputs. As the name says, a component gets now its input value in the form of a signal. The input decorator gets replaced via an input function, and they can react to the changes via the computed via the effect function, or can just access the value directly. Three flavors are available without default value. Type is generic, resulting in a union type containing undefined. Input with a default value resolves to a signal of one particular type. Last one is input required, which comes without default value and the union type. Be aware that input required might throw a runtime error if you access the value before the component is initialized, or the parent component manages somehow to not pass the value down to the child component. Transformation functions for type mapping and parameter binding from the router are also available. For testing, the web test runner is now available in an experimental mode. It will replace Karma, which runs Jasmine test inside of the browser. There are no plans to deprecate or to remove Jasmine. There were some speculations about support for zoneless applications. You can disable zone.js and use the new scheduler, which triggers change detection in mark4check. The new scheduler, though, is not even an experimental feature, it's an internal one. So think twice before you use it. NG Update will not migrate to signals. There is a community plugin though from Jaotron, which will help you get started. For more information, read the change logs, look out for various blog articles, and follow NG News. Have a nice week. See you in the next episode. Goodbye.